Now, I had a bit of a think, a market research society, what would I recommend for cocktails for all of you? I know, sitting through many a viewing session for research groups, you all like a bit of a drink. So I'd recommend a Harlem mugger. It does what it says. It creeps up on you and knocks you out. So just be a bit careful when you're ordering that one. So Dominic sort of talked to you a bit about the project and, you know, navigating our way through life. And really what I want to do is focus on really two points from that. A, you don't need to discount. And B, that if you've got a really strong brand and you understand that through good insight, you can be very, very successful. And that's really what I'm going to try and hopefully show you in a light-hearted visual way. Now, I'm conscious I'm a little bit old, and whenever I go out there and talk to our core audience, they've got very little history to Fridays and very little idea what it stands for. So I thought I'd take a little quick whistle-stop tour of what Fridays was about. Established 1965 in New York. This actually is Birmingham, the very first Fridays in the UK, 1986. And it's really important you understand the context of when Fridays arrived. And I think we talked a little bit about, I'll come on to the food piece that John mentioned. You know, it was the land and the time of Wimpy, you know, Little Chef. That was it. You're very, you know, used to lots of exciting and aspirational places to eat and drink and dine and enjoy yourselves. Life back in 1986 was very different. This is putting the rowing boat in the restaurant. Every restaurant has a rowing boat. It is quirky, it's a bit different, it's unusual, but it stands for a lot. There's a lot of science behind Fridays, and it stands for teamwork, pulling together in the right direction to achieve stuff. And really that, to me, is some of the foundations that's been the ability for us to be successful by going back to some of our roots. Food. This is the Alaskan snow crab. In 1986, this was pretty powerful on the menu. No one had seen this. A lot of our food about theatre. Colour, aspiration, uniqueness. And even then, funny enough, in the time of the Euro, an ability to have something that's different from the norms. Cocktails. I think it was 1984 cocktail came out. Tom Cruise flaring. And, you know, a lot of theatre in how cocktails are delivered and presented. So something that's very unique around the drinking environment. But most importantly, the thing that sets Fridays apart from when it was first originated was the service. You go back to the days of greasy spoons, there wasn't much service, no one really cared about you. And Fridays was established on a brand that really cared about giving the guest experience with the guest. So, 2008, the system broke. The fundamentals of what people understood and the normality and the trust of society fell down. And we were faced with really two tough decisions. Do we discount and follow the market, or do we change direction and try and invest for success? And we really spent a lot of time, a lot of the research, a lot more of the background of the brand. And we decided that actually we were going to go back to what made us different. Go back to some of those philosophies from 1986 that set us apart. And really try and invest in the experience, the guest experience, but make it relevant for today. And that's really crucial. And you saw that a lot of the imagery of the fast food product, the products there. Go back to what made the brand relevant, but made it exciting and different, but make it relevant for today. And I think the most important part of our journey and our story has been about the people. We've set ourselves apart because of the culture. You can copy any food and drink and service and environment, but what you cannot copy is the culture and how that's delivered. And that's the piece that really has been the most success in the journey we've taken over the last 3 years. So I'm going to just refer to some of the insights that Dominic put up there that we took from the project. Value for money does not mean low price, definitely not. We positioned this about, and this is the things I'm talking to you about today live and breathe in our business. If you go into any of the restaurants and ask them, they should be able to quote a lot of this to you. It's really about how we make you feel. We concentrate on the guest experience, the emotional benefit that we deliver. Mainstream diners want familiarity. I mean, the brand's been around for 25 years. It's pretty much stayed the same in food and drink. But they also want the ability to experiment and be exciting and be a bit different. So we've tried to garner safe food adventure in how we develop that. Theatre and involvement and experience is more than just the food. And I think that's the key fundamental that's differentiated Fridays. We stand for the philosophy that it's different in here. That's our brand essence. That is what you see on the walls in all our restaurants. A big statement to that, a big statement to being different. So I'm just going to take each of those insights and talk to you a little bit about what we've done over the last 3 years and show you that it is possible to be different. So where we make you feel? Well, we started off in 2009 changing our vision. We had a lovely vision, make 10 million quid, grow the business, you know, world domination, the usual rubbish you see. And we started off with a culture that was based around how people feel. So we started with the belief that we want our team members, our people, to be family, we want our guests to become friends, and I want our competitors to envy us. That's our vision. That's what we're trying to achieve. And we established a mission, only Friday's people serving Friday's food and Friday's restaurants. Very simple. But we jealously guard everything about Fridays. Who gets to play, the food we serve, the environment we create, and the ability to generate a different experience to everybody else. We set about giving new values to the way we run the business. We have three very clear values: pride, passion, personality. Pride in the job you do, that you care about serving. A passion to do it with your all. But most importantly, a personality that you don't lock yourself away and adopt the norms of the jigsaw approach of a lot of brands. Actually, you get to show a little bit of you in how you do your job.